I remember quite well. One evening, when I happened to be coming home, when I'd been with a mate of mine, we'd been shooting somewhere, and we were coming home one night, I was dropping him off, and he lived at a farmhouse on a bit of a corner, a bit of cul-de-sac, and we turned into this little lane, and I'd got the headlights on, and as I turned in, it's late, it's about 12:30, 1 o'clock in the morning, and there was a car, you know, standing, well, it was kind of got a little bit of a rock on it, you know, and he said, put the headlights out, you know, you wouldn't like it, you know what I mean? Anyway, I put the headlights out, and we were just having a smoke before he went in, and just then there was a knock on my side, and a young woman stood there. She said, oh, can you help me? I thought, God, rape, you know. That time of the night, can you help me? You know, what help would I be? Anyhow, so I said, yes, certainly, miss, or is it madam? Anyhow, she says, will you come up to the car? And I go up to this car, one of these cars with reclining front seats and both doors are open. You know, there's a bloke lying face down going, oh, oh, making a horrible noise in terrible pain. And he's lying there, and the moon is shining through the windscreen on his bare, pimply bottom, you know, which was a nauseating sight, I fancy, at the best of time, especially in a bloody moonlight, it's worse, you know. I said, what's up with him? I thought, he's had a stroke. You know, I mean, one of them strokes. Yeah. So, she said, he's stuck. I thought, no, that's a... Then he's stuck. How's he... And I looked, and I followed his right leg up, and his foot disappeared into his glove compartment. And it was twisted round, and the foot itself had gone in the glove compartment, and I suppose it had doubled his shoe back, and the bloody welt of his shoe wouldn't let it come out again. And then she'd come to get help, well, you can imagine, from a semi-recumbent position, and it put all the weight on his bloody shin and it made it worse. Yo! You see, she says, can you help me? I said, certainly, I'll take the weight off him. You double his foot up and wrench it out of that glove compartment. We both pulled together. So I drew the bags over his bottom, and I said, are you ready now? And she goes, oh, bump, and he bumped his head on the back seat. I said, that'd be a lesson to you, miss. Tell him to keep his contraceptives in his ashtray in future. Yes. Oh, Christ.